sekerit lah. Despite considerable media speculation, neither the highly anticipated election commission report on the new constituency redelineation proposals, which the election commission submitted to the Prime Minister on March the 9th, nor the Prime Minister's motion to give effect to the election commission's new constituency proposals are on the table of MPs today. I call on the Speaker of Parliament, Panika, to ensure that Parliament does not become a rubber stamp to approve the Prime Minister's constituency redelineation proposals without ample time for MPs to study them and to get public feedback. As correctly pointed out by the Brisbane Acting Chairperson Sharul Aman, Najib can, under Section 9 of the 13th Schedule of the Constitution, further alter the Election Commission's final report on the redrawing of electoral constituencies before tabling it to Parliament. The PM can, for instance, as Yaming has mentioned just now, reinstate the Election Commission's first constituency redelineation proposals for Selangor, which have been substituted by the Election Commission's second constituency redelineation proposals. In the EC's second constituency redelineation proposals for Selangor, only 5 parliamentary constituencies will be affected, as compared to 18 in the first proposal. The 5 parliamentary constituencies affected are Tanjung Karang, Kuala Selangor, Gombak, Ampang and Pandan. EC's first proposal has suggested boundary changes for Selayang, Ulu Langat, Panggi, Puchong, Kelantan Jaya, PJ Selatan, PJ Utara, Subang, Shah Alam, Kapar, Klang, Kota Raja dan Kuala Langat, in addition to the 5 constituencies. Under the EC's first irradiation proposal, for instance, PJ Utara, presently held by Tony Poa, will be turned into Damansara by merging PJU with parts of Selayang, Bukit Lanjang, Sungai Buloh and Kepong. It will turn P106, which is PJ Utara, into a massively populated seat, increasing from 85,000 to almost 150,000 voters, thus making it one of the largest seats in the country. Furthermore, the proposed Damansara parliamentary constituency will have 4 times more voters than Sabah Bernam and about 10 times that of Putrajaya. Is there a guarantee that the PM will not reinstate such a proposal, which is most ridiculous, outrageous and the most undemocratic gerrymandering at its worst? Once the Elections Commission's new constituency redelineation report are tabled in the House of Parliament, Parliament should set up a parliamentary select committee to study the report and the Prime Minister's proposals. And I urge the Minister in the PM's department, Azalina, to discuss with the opposition leader, Wan Aziza, on the membership of this parliamentary select committee. Parliament should not be held to ransom because of the impending 14 GE to become a rubber stamp to approve the executive's proposal on new constituency redelineation, for this will be a grave abdication responsibility by Parliament and the latest great blow to the doctrine of separation of powers among the executive, legislature and the judiciary.